CCCH students, it's Pastor Dan here on a Monday morning giving you your quick update for all things CCCH students. We're so excited for the week we just had around CCCH and also the week we have coming up. This last week on Wednesday night, we had our first takeover of 2021. We're so excited. It was so much fun. We had a roller skating night at Lombard Roller Rink. We had so many people show up. People brought friends. It was so great. Thank you for everyone who showed up and supported that. If you didn't get to come, we're so sorry. We missed you. Make sure you come to our next takeover night in March. March, we're back at the church. We're doing what we're calling Game On Night. So we're starting the night doing some crazy games, so just some fun stuff, hangout stuff, and then we're pulling everything in the auditorium for a game show. Believe it or not, a game show night on the stage. We have giveaways, we have crazy prizes, we have crazy games going on. It's a perfect day to invite a friend. Maybe you want to embarrass them a little bit, not too much, and just a lot of fun. Plus, we have some other really great takeovers coming up the rest of the year. Also, this last weekend was our Super Bowl night for our high schoolers. We had a great time at my house. We were hanging out, having a good time last night, enjoyed the game, enjoyed some specialty sodas and some floats, and it was just so much fun to hang out with you guys. So thanks for everyone who showed up here at my house and hung out with us last night. Hey, you know what? This week, we have some exciting things going on as well. This coming Sunday, next Sunday, is Valentine's Day, believe it or not, and that is our first of what we're calling Hilarious Holidays. Once a month, we're gonna celebrate a hilarious holiday. This month, it's Valentine's Day, and on Sunday, this coming Sunday, both Sunday morning and Sunday night, separately from middle school and high school, we have hilarious holiday stuff going on. We have a crazy big game, we have some stage games, with some icebreakers, just some silly, fun Valentine's-themed games, just to get going, hanging out together, having some fun. We'll have a short lesson called God is Love, part of our new God is series, and then at the end of the morning and end of the night, we have something extra special. We're gonna be doing a service project of sorts. We are gonna be writing Valentine's to the shut-ins and also the widowers of our CCCH family. It's a way for us to live out exactly what we were just talking about, the idea that God is love. What I need you to do is I make sure that you are signing up and pre-registering. We are still limited on numbers based on COVID currently. So we want to make sure that we have enough chairs for everyone, especially on Sunday morning. We've added 5 more seats to our middle school 10:45 service. So make sure you sign up. Sign up will start probably within the next couple of minutes as you're watching this video. Every Monday morning, the sign-ups start. High schoolers as well, sign up, let us know you are coming. We always have a few seats left for you guys, but we want you to invite friends, both groups. This is an opportunity for you to invite friends. And here's the deal. If our middle schools especially, if we end up filling up those 30 seats every single Sunday morning at 10:45, coming in March, we're gonna start working on seeing if we wanna open up a 9 a.m. service. So if you are signing up, sign up now, let us know you're coming so we can kind of start making sure that we have a spot for you. If you, for some reason, sign up and the setup is full, I have left you my email, so email me along with your cell phone and we will call you, make sure that we know what's going on. Maybe we can find you a spot if someone drops out, but we're trying to do our absolute best to keep everyone safe and healthy and having a great time together Sunday morning, Sunday night. So do not miss out this coming week. If you've not seen the rest of our schedule, make sure you download our schedule, look at our website, see all the schedules of all the takeover nights, all the hilarious holidays, and also some of the fun stuff coming up. And then we have these videos like we make every single week. You can look back at them, you can share with your family, your friends, and just make sure that you keep up on what's going on. We know there's a lot of reasons why you might be able to show up every single Sunday. Sports have started to pick back up again, which is so exciting. So let us know what is going on in your world that way, but keep up with what's going on in our world as well. Well, Sunday morning, we shared a little something special. We did a one single series lesson called Who's Your Provider? We talked about this idea of God and our connection to Him. Our first original wireless connection to God is prayer. We spent this last Sunday morning with our middle schoolers talking about the idea of prayer. We've spent a whole lot of time talking about GPS. How do we connect to God through His Word? And part of that has been talking about this idea of praying. Make sure you're praying as you're reading God's Word. But we wanted to address the fact that sometimes we just don't know how to pray. Maybe we were not really sure how to pray. So what we did is we looked at the Lord's Prayer, the way that Jesus taught His disciples to pray. And what we learned is the prayer that He taught them was not a prayer to be repeated, but as a model, as a kind of a way for us to understand how to pray. And so as we look through that passage, we did something special with our journals. If you've not got a student ministry journal, make sure you grab one this coming Sunday. We asked every single student to sit down with their journal and rewrite the Lord's Prayer in their own words. What we'd love to do is I would challenge you the same way. If you weren't there this week, look at your journal, grab your journal, find your journal, find maybe a piece of paper, you don't have a journal, and look at the Lord's Prayer and then rewrite it in your own words just as a way to reflect. But I want you to look at the Lord's Prayer as a way to understand what God is giving us. God was giving us a way to see the way we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. We talked about the fact that the first part of the verse is all about our God. It's our God. It's affirmation. It's adoration and it's acceptance. It's our God. We adore God. God, we love you. So we start off our prayers, not about us, but about him. We love you, God. Adoring him, right? It's something like, oh, we think about him being adorable. But we think adoration is this idea of loving God and seeing God for who he is. And then we talk about affirmation. We put God first in our prayers. You are God, and we affirm that you are God. We cheer you on. God, you are good. And then we put into this idea of acceptance. God, whatever your will is, we accept that. Right? And that's what we talked about. We kind of wrote those down in our journals. What does it look like for us to pray seeking God, accepting who he is and what he has for our life, and then beginning to understand what God has laid out for us? So for three things we talked about on Sunday morning, which also reflect on, is this idea of provision, pardon, and protection. That as we look at the Lord's Prayer, what we know as the Lord's Prayer, is the second half is all about us. Is this the point when we began to seek God? God, provide for us, not our wants, but our needs. That's important for us to understand about prayer, is so often we kind of pray for what we want, but we really need to focus on what we need and let God provide the extra blessing. So provide. Then we asked for pardon. God, forgive us. God has forgiven us if we're saved, but we need to continue to clean up our lives and go back to him and say, you know, God, I love you. I know you forgive me, but I know some things in my life I've messed up on this week. It's like my wife and I, when we're married, we don't stop being married when we mess up, but we need to continue to work on our relationship and say, hey, you know what? I really love you. You know what? This week I didn't act right the way I should have. Forgive me for how I acted. In the same way, God doesn't get rid of you, you don't lose your salvation, but God simply says, hey, I want to hear from you. I want to know. And we keep that strong connection with him by continuing to say, God, pardon me, forgive me for what I did. Not for eternity, but forgive me for what I did this week. Let me clean up my life again. And the last thing is this idea of protection. Lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. We ask God to help us with the things that we messed up on, that we don't mess up again, but that we leave behind temptation and that we ask him to protect us so that we won't fall into the same bad habits again. What I want you to do is, as I said, just take your journal out this week. We're trying to encourage you to get into God's word. Use your inductive Bible study. Use your SOAP method. Use whatever method that you find easiest for you to help you understand God's word. But then also, as part of that, spend some time this week praying. Looking me back at the Lord's Prayer as a model. God, here's who you are. Here's why I love you. And we want to honor you and accept whatever you have for us. And then praying and maybe making a list in your journal of the things that you are going through right now that you need help with, or you need maybe something in your life. Man, God, I really need your help. But also maybe in your journal, maybe remember, not really comfortable with it or not, but maybe writing down a few things that you want God to forgive you for, some things you may need to work on, but also maybe write down some ways that God can protect you. Write some things down and say, hey, God, I really need your protection in these moments. This week, I want this week to be a week for you to really continue to plug into God. Because the next couple of series we're going to be in, the next series we're in, is all about who God is. We're going to talk about who God is. We're going to talk about God is love, God is divine, God is good, and God is real. So as we plug you into God's word, plug you into prayer, we also want to plug you into who God is. So hopefully see you this coming Sunday morning, Sunday night. As always, we love you. We really enjoy spending time with you. Make sure that if you have anything going on in your world, you can email us, call us, stop by the office. We would love to connect with you and see how we can serve you and your family. Talk to you guys very, very soon.